Well, name-calling certainly doesn't seem to have hurt Donald Trump among his supporters, but how do religious leaders feel about the way the conversation is going? Joining me now is Liberty University President Jerry Falwell Jr., who's a Trump supporter. Jerry, thanks so much for being with us. When you hear Donald Trump refer to Elizabeth Warren as Pocahontas, when he calls Secretary Clinton a lowlife, do you take issue with that at all? Is that a Christian thing to do, in your opinion?
Well, I'm president of a university. We have a Division I football team, and we have lots of players who might have relatives or friends on opposing teams, but when the whistle blows, it's every man for himself. And I think politics is the same way. And I think it's the way the game is played. It's a blood sport, and I wouldn't expect anything less from somebody who wants to win the presidency.
I know you said that people should stop trying to choose political leaders who they believe are the most godly because only God knows people's hearts. What about judging candidates according to their actions? I mean, isn't that really the only way to assess who a candidate is, what they actually believe in?
No, I think the way to assess a candidate is their experience. I think with Donald Trump, his experience and success in the private sector is one of the reasons I chose to support him, because I've been president. Before that, I was general counsel of a university that was in financial trouble in the 80s and 90s, and we brought in the best experts to make it the most prosperous university in the country now, one of the most prosperous, I should say. And it's, I think the country needs the same type of, I think the country needs a doctor who has the cure for America's ills. I think we're at a turning point. I think we could lose our country if we don't choose the right president this time. And I think Donald Trump is the man for this point in history.
I wonder what you worked obviously closely with your dad, who founded the Moral Majority. What do you think he would have made of Donald Trump?
I think he was roundly criticized for supporting Ronald Reagan over Jimmy Carter, who was a Southern Baptist Sunday school teacher. Ronald Reagan was a Hollywood actor who had been divorced, remarried. Everybody said my dad was an apostate for supporting somebody like Reagan. But Reagan turned out to be a much better president for issues that Christians were concerned about than Jimmy Carter was. And I think you have to look past. You can't be, we're not electing a pastor-in-chief. We're electing a commander-in-chief. And we can't expect our commander-in-chief to have the same qualities as our pastors. And I think most of the rank-and-file evangelicals have figured that out on their own. I think some of the leadership has been slow to catch up with the rank and file. I think if you look all through the primaries, Donald Trump has had the evangelical support, maybe not a plurality when there were 15 or 16 candidates in the race, but now that it's just, now that it's just down to two or one, or even when it was down to two, he was roundly beating Cruz with the evangelicals. And I think it's because evangelicals are voting on different issues this time. I think they're concerned about the same issues that the general population is concerned about. I had one pastor tell me that if we don't secure our borders, if we don't rebuild our military to fight terrorism, if we don't do something about the terrible debt problem, then the social issues are going to be a moot point. We've got to save our country first, and then maybe next time we look at who can help with social issues. But for right now, we're in a bad situation, and the Supreme Court issue alone. I had a law student do a report for me the other day. With a four-year Hillary or Bernie presidency, the Supreme Court could move to 7-2 liberal, and if those new appointees are young people, that's the court will be a liberal court for the next generation. That's something that should concern every Christian, every conservative voter, and I think at the end of the day, the few that are still on the fence about Trump because they don't like his behavior will do what's best for the United States and will elect Donald Trump.
We've had Dr. Russell Moore on the program a lot, and he says that having to choose between Donald Trump and most likely Hillary Clinton, many evangelicals are, in his words, horrified that evangelicals are facing what he calls a real crisis right now. Is he wrong? He's obviously not a supporter of Donald Trump. How do you see his position from an evangelical standpoint?
I think there's always been a small group of evangelicals who tend to vote Democratic, and I think there's there's certain leadership that's been criticized, certain evangelical leadership that's been criticizing Trump lately. They tend to be more lean toward more the Democratic side. So I think that's who you're hearing from. I think Jim Wallace, for example, they those leaders are only represent a very small segment of evangelicalism. The vast majority, tens of millions of evangelicals, are conservative voters. And there's still a small group of them that are still undecided, but they're a very small minority. I've watched the percentage, just in contacts that I have, just increase. I've had evangelical leaders who were never part of the Never Trump movement who contact me in the last few weeks, ask me how they can get involved. These are African-American evangelical leaders, Hispanic leaders, white leaders, just all across the spectrum.
It is a fascinating thing because I remember early on in the campaign when Donald Trump appeared, I think it was at a Faith and Values forum, and he made a comment about sort of about communion and taking, you know, the little wine, the little crackers. I remember Eric Erickson at Red State wrote that he could now write off evangelical support, which, as you pointed out, was completely not the case. I mean, Donald Trump has won evangelicals throughout this. And I do think that surprises certainly a lot of people. Is it that, I mean, you described it very well earlier, but is it, I mean, are evangelicals putting aside, I mean, kind of thinking, well, okay, he may have, you know, things in his past, he may have indiscretions, he may not be the standard bearer for the evangelical movement, but that's not what we need right now? Is that essentially what it boils down to?
That's exactly where most of them are now. I talk to them every day, and it's just, we've got to save the country first. It's just like if you had a sick child who needed a doctor, you would want the doctor most qualified to treat that child, not necessarily a doctor that shares your faith. And that's where, I think Donald Trump's the doctor that can cure the ills of America right now. And I think that's where the rank and file of evangelicals are. I mean, the press always interviews the leader, quote, leadership. But the evangelicals, the rank and file, don't listen to that leadership. They think for themselves, and they come to their own conclusions. And it really doesn't matter what that leadership says. What matters, they sort of look at that leadership as the establishment of the evangelical movement. And this is an election where all the establishment has been rebuffed, including the evangelical establishment. And I think that's a good thing.
We've obviously done a lot of reporting over the last couple of months about opinions about Hillary Clinton. And you know, when polls are done, people say dishonest, untrustworthy, although certainly among Democrats, those numbers are far less. But in a general electorate, Donald Trump has the similar issues about running about the same on sort of dishonesty. Do you think he is an honest man?
I very much think he's an honest man. I've gotten to know him well. And I've talked to his employees and his family, and that's really how you can tell if somebody is genuine. It's what their family and their employees and their friends think of them. And he is loved by everybody around him. The time I spent with him, he was serving my family cheeseburgers from Wendy's, and it wasn't the help that was serving; it was him. And it was he's very personable. And he wouldn't have gotten as far as he has in business if he was dishonest, if he was in any way had any sort of integrity failures. I'm convinced he's honest. He might be a little brash, but that's what we need. We need a president who's willing to fight our enemies, to take the battle to them, to not be afraid, to not back down. And I think Donald Trump's that man. I've always said that, and I supported him early on because of his financial background and because of my experience in turning a university around financially. So I saw what was required. So I'm a little different than most. I'm not a minister, I'm a lawyer. So I'm a little different than most of the evangelical leadership in that regard. But that was the impetus of my support.
Well, Jerry Falwell Jr., it's a pleasure to have you on. I really do appreciate it.
Yeah, it's good to be with you, Anderson.